Victory. It's Marcus Mariota's Titans going up against Lug's Colts. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Just a short time ago, smoke from the pyrotechnics filled the dome as the Colts made their way out of the locker room. We're set for football as the Colts get set to match up with Marcus Mariota and the Tennessee Titans. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And, you know, now more than ever, it's a passing league. We know that. And as Larry hit onto the open, we've got a couple of great passers squaring off here this afternoon.
And usually the discussion centers in on how they're going to compete against the opposite defense. But you and I had a nice little chat with one of these guys in this game. And they did say, look, I'm always competing against the opposite quarterback. If I play better than he does, I think my team has an advantage.
Makes the handshake afterwards a little sweeter, too. On the return, it's Josh Ferguson. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, the Stanford man. It's Andrew Luck.
I love everything about Andrew Luck's game, but I also love his worldliness. Some of his formative years were spent growing up outside of the United States. I think that that's helped him when he came back because now he's seen the world. I think that helped him mature a little bit as well.
Here's the first carry now for Frank Gore. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That good for 19 and a first down.
It should go without saying that anytime you run the football well and gain a nice chunk of yardage, that means the offensive line did their job and did it really well. But let's give them a little more credit than that. Because all week long, offensive line meetings, they're going over adjustments, counters, when the line shifts, all those things that go along with it. And yet, you still have to be physical. And that's what they did on the first play.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. From the gun, here's Love. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Wesley Woodyard. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Interception here, Mariota. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And got his man, complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Now that play will end up on the highlights and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play pop. Coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably trailing on the headset right now, Sam. We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. First down, Murray. A big hit. Knocked down sideways. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
I believe Madden 18 for some favorite plays, so yes, I'm probably going to get my butt kicked a few times if I learn this game, but that is okay. Please feel free to comment down below if you want.
This is Derrick Henry, and he will score. Touchdown, Titans.
I am the Colt.
Derrick Henry, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments. Let them run it in. They did.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Ryan Succupon for the point after. And this is good. Our score, 7-0 Tennessee. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And the Colts getting ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he is out of bounds, getting it across the 30-yard line. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis, and also moved the sticks.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Here's the offense, and if you're the defense, Charles, you really have to focus on that guy that's highlighted on the screen.
You're talking about pure speed. T.Y. Hilton can get down the middle of the field and really stretch a defense.
To throw on 2nd down is Locke. And a reception made by Dante Moncrief. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. What connecting with Moncrief for the Indianapolis first. Well, no matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are. You throw an interception, it's going to get to you a little bit. But the ones that we've seen that are the best, you never notice it. They don't come to the bench, throw their helmets. They don't do any of that. Just go back out the next drive and act like it never happened. And that's what we're seeing here.
Here's Locke. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. 3 yards remaining here on second down. Luck gives to his running back, Gore. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Hey. 6 yards to go here on second down. Shotgun snap for Luck. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Luck fighting his emerging tight end Doyle for a Colt first. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Luck on first down. And he's caught at the 7. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
As far as I'm concerned, Andrew Luck can do it all. I mean, he's an underrated runner, toughness in the pocket, strong and stout. But let's face it, the money, that comes from his arm.
And smart, valedictorian of his high school class in Houston, then he goes to Stanford. He's got it all. After that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll try and run. This is Turbin. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Robert Turbin, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run, end result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Now Adam Vinatieri for the point after. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
I don't know if anybody can hear me, but
the Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. They had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business.
I had ball first possession.
Now that they're back on the field. I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position, and we just saw there some linebackers that go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 12 yards is the pickup there, and they'll be faced with a third and inches. Getting the sense Charles are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And before they can get settled in here, time expires. On the first quarter of action, 7-7 is the score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number two, but they've got a third and inches coming up, trying to keep the chains moving. They'll run here. It's Murray. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Here on first down, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Still needing 10 yards. Second down. Mariota to throw it. Complete to the tight end, Jason Morrow. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A very solid gain of 27.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
To the ground game. Here's Murray. And that is what you call a hit stick. Put down to the ground hard.
That was a good one right there.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action. Hit them over the top.
It's like somebody has joined in. It'd be nice if you can come in and let me know who you are, where you're from. That'd be great. Welcome.
23-yard line. They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
So much again, this is Madden 18, I believe. First time ever playing it.
Freezing the defense just enough.
Could be some learning curve for me.
Downfield for the completion.
Here's Mario, option left, and they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27, and a loss of three to bring up four.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play, because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss.
Yeah, fourth down. Yeah, fourth down. So I guess they're
here's Ryan
Suckup here
for the Titan field goal. This from 44 yards out, left hash.
Oh,
and
almost.
Will put this
oh,
one right
almost.
Through.
All right,
and
so
they take
10
the lead
to 7
here
now.
Get the
ball
back
here.
So the scoring drive encompasses nine plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the three and move on. Always better than nothing.
Suckup now set to kick it off following the made field goal. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. We focus our attention on the Titans' defense now. And in a tight ball game like this, the defense looking for a stop. You kind of, if whether you're the offense or the defense, you don't want to be the one to screw this thing up.
No, not at all. And right now, you've got to figure that the offense is thinking to themselves, if you just get us the ball, we'll make things happen for you. Just help us out a little bit. And that's what the defense has to have in mind as they trot out here for this series.
Yeah, right now, the offense on the sideline. Can the defense do it? Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there. And it'll be second down.
The name of the game is always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
Caught left side by Hilton. T.Y.
Look at that. Oh, my goodness. What did I just do? Oh, it's going to touch down. Ha-ha, yeah. 75 yards. Yeah. Like I did that. Like I knew what I was doing.
And the Colts have taken the lead.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field, and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. And that makes it 14-10. Drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone.
All right, I got the lead here, so that's good.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Adoree Jackson on the return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And right now we spotlight DeMarco Murray. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah. Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects
good
of running
play there.
Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. That was second down run for Murray. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the run play
just,
on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going into the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Pass the ball.
On third down, Mariota.
Come on.
Oh, Matthews.
Nice play.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go
there
to
you go.
Because he can trust you being in the right
spot.
That
was a good one. Yeah.
And they connected there and picked up a first down.
That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that'll make this a second and 13.
So when you call a corner blitz, what a lot of teams call a cat blitz, You're expected to come after the quarterback, but in this case, into the ball carrier. Really nice technique, because what you do is you come deep as the deepest offensive player, so he can't get outside of you.
Oh, good job on that
there.
Ball.
It's out of bounds, incomplete. One of his main targets, Delaney Walker,
because
the
I have three people
receiver.
Watching, so welcome. Please feel free to comment who you are, where you're from.
I think that's what you need to do to
keep
the offense
playing
guessing.
Madden 18. Never played this game before. So I'm learning.
Third and long here for Mario.
I'm winning right now, though, so that's good.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles
punt the ball.
And be tied in, but he couldn't.
Right.
Yeah, get into that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies unable
nice
to
job
get it
on the
done.
Defense.
On his
current
the punter
shank it.
To
he
send
shank
this
it.
One away. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. And we
all
take
right.
some time to spotlight T.Y. Hilton now.
That's good.
Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty
yes,
darn
I would
good
like two
number there.
Ball.
Number of catches, but he's shredding defense. Is getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
They start on the ground here with Turbin.
There you go. Come on. High seven. There you go. Come on. Go, 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 go. Get out of the way, Russ.
He's at
oh,
the 50.
There you go.
30. 20. And he cuts touchdown Indianapolis. Robert Turbin with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Colts strike quickly here for 6 points. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. He'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Vinatieri now for the point after. It's good, and it's 21-10. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives.